I'm Kyler Phillips. I'm from the MMA Lab in Arizona, fighting out of Carlson Gracie team. My story is a little interesting. I started training since I was a little boy. Started training jiu-jitsu at the age of 3 years old. But I've always had a drive for me to fight. My dad has had me fighting in parks and in the street, and I've always wanted to be a UFC champion. And I know that I was born to do this, and so it's a good ride for me. Every day is just a learning experience. Every day is you get in the hard work, but you also balance it out with fun. The MMA Lab has just been a great home for me, and everybody there just loves me, and I love them back. And we have a great, just such a powerful team of individuals coming together. And I feel so special there, and I feel at home. And that's why I love what I do, and that's why I love MMA, because not just what I do, but who I do it with, and that's the most important thing to me. Head coach John Crouch, he's been an amazing friendship and an amazing coach to me. He knows how to break things down, and he knows how to put things together. He knows how to take your weaknesses and to take your strengths and use those both to your advantage. I trust him. I trust him with my career, and I trust him with my fight game. And Hanchi Nico has guided me very well throughout the last 2 years. Everything from karate to Muay Thai and different types of styles, he's helped me understand, you know, the basics of all this stuff and to bring it together. He's helped me not just to understand, but to have my own style, which is similar to my jiu-jitsu. And that's why it's been so effective for me, because I'm so comfortable in there and I feel so at home. When I'm moving around, I just feel the second nature. Throughout high school, doing jiu-jitsu and wrestling has kept me out of trouble. I've just always been consistent. That's been the most important thing. Whether I got injured or whether something happened on the side, I was still always at jiu-jitsu and wrestling. You know, I was always there. I stayed consistent with my goals, and I put in the time. I think that's the most important thing, is putting in the time, because, you know, just hours and hours on the mat, not just physical work, but mental work, you know, dedicating yourself and just having a good time. I've met a lot of great people throughout jiu-jitsu, and a lot of great experiences. Throughout jiu-jitsu, I have learned a lot of good lessons, and I've learned how to beat bigger opponents. I've learned how to grow in confidence. I've learned how to understand life itself. And jiu-jitsu has brought me to where I am right now, and I'm very thankful for that. Professor Tom Cronin, one of my best friends, has always been for me in the past few years, and he's always sponsored me for tournaments, and he's allowed me to grow in jiu-jitsu, brought me to places when I needed training partners, and has been there as a big brother for me. But Tom, he's always had his eye on me. He's always made sure I was here, and all throughout high school, I wasn't out doing dumb things. I was here at the gym twice a day. I was training, and Tom was always there, just helping me out.
Started training with us, I want to say around 2009. Incredibly talented kid. He had been doing like some no-gi submission wrestling and stuff with his dad at various locations in the area, and the kid jumped right in with 2 feet. Came every day, trained his butt off, and just was a sponge and wanted to learn everything possible. Any instructor would be lucky to have him. To me, he's more like my little brother. You teach the kid, he learns, he teaches it to someone else, and he's super humble, really hard worker, just raised by a good family, and he's willing to do whatever it takes to get to the top.
Being a fighter, it means a lot to me, because I was born to fight, and I feel that this is it's a part of me, so it really is just, it means being myself, embracing my mentality, my spirituality, and my physical life, putting it all together, just being a warrior and having a lot of faith and testing my character.
Jiu-Jitsu for me has made my MMA game so
so elusive and very, very unpredictable. I just want to say thank you to my mother for, you know, I have a lot of gratitude towards my mother because she has been that rock in my life that's kept me on the right path. She has that mad attitude, but she tells me, you know, her message to me is just be the best. Whatever you do, just be the best. Whatever it is, you know, be the best you can be, and you're always going to succeed. You just if you give everything you have, there's nothing left you're going to leave out there. It's just you're going to put it all out there. And that's my plan to do. I put it all out there on a daily basis, and I just get the job done. That's my main goal. Another thing is that all of us, every single one of us, we're all individuals and we're all unique in one certain way. Don't ever compare yourself to anybody else. Comparison is just, it's not healthy for growth. We need to know where we're at and just be real with ourselves. We just gotta know that we are, there's nobody in the universe just like us. There's nobody that's just like you. And you can always be unique in whatever you do. You can be the best at it in your way. And don't ever let discouragement come your way. You always block that out, and you always set your mind to inspirational thoughts. You always inspire yourself. You know, feed your mind with good wisdom, with good truth that you need. And keep yourself focused. You know, focused on the real goal, on the goal that you've been destined to do since the beginning, and that's what I'm pursuing right now.